Hey everybody, welcome to our group project. Today we're going to talk about one of the most popular and common types of website attacks, which are SQL injection attacks. Alright, so we're going to talk about first what SQL injection means, and then how do attackers perform this type of attack and how it works. Then we're going to talk about why people perform these types of attacks, what are they getting out of it, and lastly, what we can do to minimize that threat. So what does SQL injection mean? It's an attack in which malicious code is embedded in a poorly designed application and then passed to the back-end database. The malicious data then produces database query results or actions that should have never been executed. So what are the conditions that you need for this type of attack? You need a database that uses SQL, you need a user-controllable input, and you need that input to be directly used in a SQL query. So how does it work? The attacker inserts the payload or executable code into a user input on a vulnerable website. When the server queries the database, the malicious code executes. A simple example of this is inserting password or 1 equals 1 into the password field on the website. Since 1 equals 1 is a true statement, and the query says that it can be used instead of the password, the server will log the attacker in without a password. So what benefit do attackers get out of this attack? Once an attacker is in the database, they can do whatever they want, including bypass authentication or even impersonate specific users. They can download complete data residing on a database server. They can void transactions, alter balances and other records, delete data from a database, and even use the attack as the initial vector to an attack on an internal network. So now that we know what a SQL injection attack is and how it works, we can talk about what to do to minimize the threat of an attack. You need to validate user input on the server side, use command parameters, explicitly cast user input, and use scanning tools to look for vulnerabilities in your software. So there are many types of injection attacks and they are very common. It is the responsibility of the owner and the administrator to protect their data. Hopefully this video has helped you understand and begin to take steps to protect your data from SQL injection attacks. Thanks for watching.